Hey guys, my name is Artur Azizov. I am CEO and founder of B2 Broker Group of Companies. And today I'm so excited to inform you that we have been released our second version of B2B in Pay. We have been waiting this day for last 2 years, and today that's what happened, and we are ready to present it to you. So guys, what is B2B in Pay? B2B in Pay is top 3 cryptocurrency payment processing provider. Nowadays, it's a leading technology in terms of crypto processing, simplest access to all major blockchains and all tokens based on those blockchains. Of course, there are all major stable coins. You can process, you can store, you can exchange, you can hold, you can receive, you can make a payout. So you're able to do with crypto everything you want, everything you wish, everything you can just imagine. It's one comprehensive access to all leading and all major blockchains, tokens, and stable coins. That's what B2B in Pay as of today. And we are happy to be here and present this solution for you. Guys, I would like to share with you the little story about how we have launched our B2B in Pay project. So back in 2016, B2B in Pay, it used to be a card processing company. So we have been processing cards for forex brokers, for merchants, and we have been going through so many obstacles, difficulties, because we were working at that time as a third-party solution, and we didn't have a license, and it was like three-party contracts between bank acquirer, between us as a technology provider, and between the merchant. So we realized that the profitability is very low, and the headache of all this process is very high, and we realized that, you know, it doesn't make sense to do so, but we didn't know what to do. But at that time, in November 2016, I do remember that day. I will never forget about that, that Bitcoin at that time, November 2016, hit $800 level. So, and at that time, we started receiving a lot of requests from our clients, from our white label, that guys, please, can you add to your liquidity pool Bitcoin dollar in order to give to our clients liquidity for this popular instrument, because their clients, they were asking about these instruments also. So, and then, if you remember, April 2017, at that time in Japan, has released their first legislation. So it was one of the first crypto regulation in the world. And at that day, Bitcoin hit his first $1,000 level. Since that day, it started panic. It started, I don't know, everybody was screaming about Bitcoin. So this is why we realize that, you know, if so many users, potential like individual users, traders, just investors, just normal people, you know, so everybody were looking for how to buy Bitcoin, how to store it, how to send, how to accept, because nobody has clue what to do with crypto. Everybody knew about crypto, about Bitcoin, but nobody has a clue what Bitcoin does mean and what to do with it, how to store it, what is the technology behind this blockchain. So this is why at that moment we realized that all our clients, all our counterparties, all our, you know, corporate clients, everybody will start definitely work with crypto technology, and we realize that we have to start dealing with that. And our first decision, and this is still one of the best my decision so far ever that I have made in my life, at that time we decided to reorient our B2B pay from card processing to crypto processing. So basically, we started developing our crypto processing interface for the clients. Of course, we needed to figure out with all the blockchains, with all APIs of all blockchains. Then we had to think about the logic behind what to do. So we initially, of course, we took a look on the like first competitors, let's say. Yeah, at that time we took a look on BitPay, on BitGo. You know, we understood what they are doing, how they are doing, you know. And then, of course, we decided that we can do better. We implemented like several new features. We implemented a new logic, and that's how two our solutions have appeared on the market. First, it was merchant solutions for any merchants. It could be, I don't know, forex broker, merchant, online seller, whatever. Any merchant who is selling any goods or any services or any products. And such merchants, typically, they even don't want to deal with crypto. They even don't want to touch this crypto. And we thought, okay, if they don't basically care about crypto, so we have to give them just tool how they can receive or how they can accept crypto from their users and get paid in fiat. Basically, they don't want to deal directly with crypto. They want to use crypto only as one of their payment methods on their website. That's how we came up with this merchant solution for them. And this merchant solution still perfectly suits the merchant's needs, because many merchants, they don't want even to hear about crypto. They don't even care about crypto technology. So what they care about is only how to give the simplest way to their users in order to be able for them to pay to merchants through crypto. Basically, it's just one of the payment methods on the line with card processing, with wire transfers, and all another possible ways of payment methods. That's how we came up with this merchant solution. At the same time, on the other hand, we started thinking about enterprise clients, because such clients like crypto brokers, like crypto exchanges, like crypto wallets, they were looking for enterprise solution. Basically, what does it mean, enterprise? Enterprise in this term means that through one single API, through one single interface, through one single logic, you have to have access or simple access to all blockchain infrastructure. That's actually what we did. That's actually what we have developed, and we are still developing this. This process will never stop. And this enterprise technology allow you to be connected to all leading or major blockchains, all stable coins, and all tokens based on those blockchains through one single API and through one single interface. It was 2017 when we have started developing our B2B InPay solution. Then through time, of course, we have been onboarding clients, and at some point we have reached the super high volume in terms of transactions, in terms of payments for merchants, for enterprise, and we realized that, you know, every new client, he wants something new, new blockchains, new tokens, new features, new level of security, new callback requests from API, so, and all other stuff. And we realized that basically this first version has to be expanded or has to be redeveloped. And in late 2018, we started thinking how to do so, and we started trying to redevelop it. We started making refactoring of the code, you know, and we did a lot of adjustments, a lot of improvements. Of course, the first version, we never stopped development because it's impossible. Any IT solution, if you stop development at least for one day, the day after tomorrow, it's going to be already old technology. So this is why any IT solution, any IT technology, especially in crypto industry or forex industry, never has to be stopped in terms of development. So this is why we never even thought about that to stop it. We were just thinking how to do it in the best and efficient way. And you know, we tried many things, but still it was the core of the solution, architecture of this solution. It was like the first version, and we couldn't change it. Otherwise, we had to redevelop from the scratch. And basically, eventually, in 2019, we decided to start developing our new version. And at that time, the main challenge was to keep up to date our first version, and this is why we had to allocate some resources there. And at the same time, we had to allocate enough resources in order to start proper development of our second version. That was our main challenge, and we couldn't understand how to do it right, you know, because here we have been getting more and more coins, our volume have been increasing higher and bigger, and this is why we couldn't lose our focus from the first version. And at the same time, we had to also make a focus on our second version, otherwise how are you gonna release it, right? Because without focus, it's impossible to do. And typically, as you know, if you have two focuses, it's not good for both parts. But this time, you know, we made strong decision to do so, and we divided teams. You know, we hired a lot of new people here. So we hired product manager, business analyst, system analyst, project managers, chief of product manager, team lead, manager of development, a lot of new developers. So we even divided development team also by three teams. The first team is taking care about back office, another team they are doing front end, the third team they are doing all the development on the blockchains, because every time, you know, you need to be up to date and in line with all new technologies which appear on the market time to time. And this is why you have to have dedicated team who is taking care about only integration with the new technologies. So, and another team, they were doing only Q&A, DevOps stuff, you know, servers, updates, and all this stuff. So basically, at some point, we reached maybe like around 35-40 people, they were taking care only about our second version. And at the same time, all our existing business operational team, they were taking care about our first version. So that's how we started development in 2019, our second version. And in 2020, we realized that on the first version, we had to stop all development and adding any new features for our first version. Now, what we were doing since 2020, we were making only the hot fixes and maybe some bugs, you know, like all only really necessary things. And starting from 2020, we made our focus only on second version, and that's allowed us to speed up the whole entire process. Also, guys, I would like to bring your attention to the fact that now around 70-80 people is taking care about B2B and pay projects. So B2B Broker Group now is around 230 people plus, and of course we never stop hiring new talents, new developers, new engineers, and new just good people in our team. But among these 230 people, around 70-80 people, they are somehow in charge with B2B and pay. So B2B and pay, of course, it's 24/7 technical support. Anytime during the Christmas, during New Year, during any celebration day, no matter what is time today, it's midnight or early morning or early evening. So anytime you can reach us out, and in 3 minutes, you can check it now. Our technical support team will reply to you. Of course, some cases take time to be resolved, but some cases that is easy for us, so could be resolved just in a couple of minutes. Of course, during the working days, during the working hours, you have access to professional account management team who is here to help to grow your business and to help to your developers to integrate this system, and of course to help you, to teach you, to make training for you how to use this system. Even the people who are not familiar with crypto industry will be educated and will be taught from our side. In next 1, 2, 3 months, they will become eventually SME. So you will know, guys, everything about blockchains and about payments, how to accept payments, how to store, hold, withdraw, pay out, everything you will know about our system. And of course, we are here to help to grow your business. Among these 70-80 people, there are, of course, marketing team. They are taking care about the marketing, traffic, exports, leads. Then sales team help to lead, to understand, to because not so many clients understand what they are looking for, you know. And our sales team, they explain to clients what is the difference between merchant and enterprise, and they help to choose the right system for their, according to their needs, of course. Then we have accounts team. As I said already, they will teach you, they will help to complete integration, they will be on the line through Slack channel, they will explain you some details. So account managers for you, it's access, it's some kind of bridge between financial department, between legal team, compliance, and all departments who are in charge with B2B and pay itself. Then of course it's a technical support team, as I said, DevOps team, Q&A team, front-end team, blockchains team, reporting team. So you know, so many departments who are in charge with B2B and pay system, and of course I am in charge as well. And any questions, let me know, I will help you out. So what is the main difference between first version and second version? Of course, first of all, we added a lot of new blockchains, we added a lot of new tokens, we designed new smart contracts for the second version, and there is huge difference between the first version and second version. Of course, thanks also to Ethereum that they made this transition upgrade to their POS version, but still now at least we are able to collect tokens without sending gas there. So basically we built a smart token collection system, which is helping us to collect all the tokens from all addresses without sending or injection their gas. Basically, if you think about that, what we are doing now on the first version, for example, you are enterprise client, so you have Exchange, let's say. Of course, bought enterprise version, so you made integration of the wallets with your trading technology, with your traders room. And for example, you onboarded 1,000 clients, 1,000 traders. So each of them opened, of course, wallets basically through registration, so they automatically receive all their addresses, wallets for all blockchains that are available on your exchange. Then, just imagine all these 1,000 users, they decided to send you stable coins, let's say USDT. So they decided to make a deposit, through USDT. Then what? You have to create for them 1,000 addresses, and all USDT that these users sent to these 1,000 deposits, somehow you have to extract from these 1,000 addresses in order to accumulate them on your root address or on your hot address, warm address. So it doesn't matter. So basically you have to extract and accumulate all of them. Basically on our first version, which we have been doing, and we are still doing this on the first version, that we give you on your virtual addresses immediately all those tokens, of course minus our commission, and all these tokens, all these balances immediately available for payouts, withdrawals, and so on. And what we have to do in order to extract all these tokens, every single night we have to run our bot, which goes through all these addresses, inject gas to all those addresses, and then extract these tokens. And we lose a lot of like money on all these transactions, and we overload every night all this Ethereum blockchain. Not basically we are doing only this, but everybody is doing so, because you don't have any other choice. And now on our second version, what basically we did, as I said, it's we developed and released smart token collection system. So, and now immediately as soon as users send tokens on one of your addresses, or users send tokens to their addresses, so then system immediately extract tokens without sending gas to particular address of the user. Just smart contract is able to extract these tokens, and smart contract pays the gas for this transaction. So in this case, we don't leave all these changes from the transactions, because on the first version you have to make sure that you send enough gas in order to withdraw transactions, and you get two transactions. First you send gas, it's a first transaction, and then you pay this gas in order to withdraw tokens. So it's two transactions you make in order to withdraw this token. Sometimes when the blockchain is overloaded, you have to pay a lot of commissions. Sometimes you remember April 2021, at some point commission on Ethereum hit $1,200. Maybe at some point it was even $1,500. At that time we had to stop processing all the tokens on Ethereum, because it was crazy, you know, it was super overloaded blockchains. It was there were like huge queue of all the transactions, and everybody was trying to bet like higher commission. So basically this inconvenience or challenge has been resolved by our development team, and now on the second version, all enterprise clients and all merchants clients will not face such kind of issues as we were facing on our first version. And the good thing that our clients on first version, they never faced such issues because all these headaches we are taking on B2B and pay side. That's why we were making our commission, because clients and merchants and enterprise clients, they are happy to work in such way because they could and they were able to use their tokens immediately and only through some time, 1 day, 2 days, sometimes we had to wait even up to 1 week in order to withdraw all these tokens from the, those addresses. Because sometimes if on the address there is just, you know, $10 and you have to spend on the commission $20, sometimes even it doesn't make sense to withdraw these tokens. And this is why we still run our bot every single night and we withdraw, so we detect commission for this particular time and we estimate how much gas we have to send to the wallets in order to be able to withdraw tokens. And if the commissions higher than the amount on the certain wallets, then we skip those wallets and we withdraw tokens where amount of balance is higher than this particular commission for this particular time. So that's what we are doing. So this is the huge difference between the first version and second version, and we are glad to tell you about that. Of course, second version contains a lot of new blockchains. We have integrated new blockchains, new tokens, new stable coins. So we have integrated 7 major tokens across all major blockchains, such as Ethereum, Binance Smart Chain, Tron, Omni, so everything. Solana and Polkadot is on the way. So now I'm going to present our new blockchains, our new stable coins and tokens, which are integrated already with both solutions, merchant and enterprise. And first we are going to discuss merchant solutions. So first of all, of course, here's the same coins and tokens that we had already on our first versions. And here we just extended this list with a couple of new blockchains such as Tron and Binance Smart Chain. So we got here Bitcoin, Bitcoin Cash, Dash, Dogecoin, Ethereum, Litecoin, Monero, Ripple, Stellar, Tron, Zcash, Binance Coin on Binance Smart Chain, and Binance Coin on Binance Chain. Binance Chain is their first blockchain, and then they copied, they copied Ethereum. You know, when we did integration, we even didn't really develop anything because it was already integrated fully with Ethereum blockchain, and this is why we just took credentials from Binance, from Ethereum, and put it into the Binance Smart Chain. So this is the major blockchains, and any merchant can accept those blockchains. Then of course stable coins. And stable coins now, guys, it's, as you know, as everybody knows already, it's one of the popular way to make a settlements between party, to make deposits, make withdrawals. Many users, they even prefer to make a withdrawal or make a deposits in stable coins. And we can see nowadays it's a huge growth of capitalization of stable coins and overall capitalization across all the major stable coins. And of course we can see here that stable coins somehow are divided now by 3 categories. And first of all, it's regulated stable coins where government agencies, they do audit, and money and trustee companies, they keep all those fiat currency that backed by this particular stable coin. Then we have the most popular USDT Tether, which is the Tether behind this stable coin. It's the most popular unregulated stable coin in the world. So the capitalization already exceeds 40 billions, and it's a huge growth since 2016 or 2017. I even don't remember when this stablecoin was appeared. And of course, the third category of the stablecoin, it's DAI. DAI, it's a decentralized stablecoin based on decentralized blockchain. Because it's very important to understand the difference between those kinds of stablecoins, because as you can see here, for example, regulated stablecoin, which is Binance USD, which is PAX, now it's called USDP, which is TUSD, and major leading regulated stablecoin, it's a USDC. So what does it mean, regulated stablecoin? Regulated stablecoin, it's a centralized token based, or centralized stable token based on decentralized blockchain. So, and here is very important to understand that emittent who is behind this token, for example, USDC, it's a company Circle, BUSD, it's a Binance US, PAX, it's a company PAX. So, and all these companies, they control smart contract of their particular token, and potentially they can block any address, any wallet belong to their smart contract. So this is very important to understand. And this is why DAI, which is a decentralized token based on decentralized Ethereum blockchain or Binance Smart Chain, which is also a decentralized blockchain, they are pretty popular because the people who are afraid that their contracts or addresses might be blocked, so they prefer, of course, and decentralized tokens. This is one of the reasons why still Bitcoin is so popular, and even in terms of transactions, but still, of course, we can see a huge drop in terms of transactions from the Bitcoin, because I do remember then that when we have just launched our BitBean Pay back in 2017, 80% of transactions, or even 90, it was Bitcoin Ethereum. Now Bitcoin Ethereum, in terms of settlements, is just 20-25%. The rest, 5-10%, it's any all other currencies, and more than 50-60%, all the transactions, they, like all the companies, all the merchants, all enterprise clients, they are making based on stable coins. And so this is why we can see huge growth across all the stable coins. And this is another reason why stable coins, all the emittents, which means the companies who is the issuer of those stable coins, they started launching all these stable coins across all other blockchains as well. Because each blockchain has own advantages and disadvantages. Some of the blockchains, such as Ethereum, they are overloaded, and sometimes you can see that many transactions, they stuck into blockchains and into this blockchain. Sometimes you can see that commissions, they jump, you know, very high, and it's unexpected situation for many merchants, for the people who do these transactions. This is why when they sign transactions and this transaction goes to the pool, and suddenly commission goes higher, and their transaction gets stuck there, and they have to cancel it and replace with the higher transaction, and another company or user, he is doing the same stuff. The all the users or senders of the transactions, they compete which transactions should be sent in the first priority. So this is why Binance USD, they of course run their token based on Ethereum, and they have Binance Smart Chain. DAI exists on Binance Smart Chain and Ethereum. USDP, which is PAX also on Binance Smart Chain and Ethereum. So then Tether is the one of the popular unregulated stable coin. Unregulated means that there is no real understanding, do they have enough assets to back all the capitalization of this Tether. It's still ongoing process of CIC, they were chasing them, then they came to conclusion that everything is settled, they paid fine, $18 million, you know, all this stuff, but still, it's one of the biggest and popular stable coin, but again, it's a centralized stable token based on decentralized blockchain, which means it's Binance Smart Chain, it's a decentralized blockchain, but stablecoin itself, it's a centralized token. Then Ethereum, then Omni, and then Tron. So Tron and Binance Smart Chain, they are most cheapest and fastest blockchains for now, if we compare to Ethereum. But of course, guys, don't forget that Ethereum is overloaded. And since Binance Smart Chain is just copy of Ethereum, as soon as Binance Smart Chain hit the same level of transactions, then everything will be the same, unless Ethereum migrates to their POS system. Then TUSD, which is TrueUSD based on Ethereum, it's not a very popular stable coin. I remember maybe one, this is one of the Hong Kong company maybe belongs behind this stable coin, but still we have it and anybody can use it. And then USDC, it's a Circle company, United States company, and they run, they are issuer of the major regulated stable coin. And I believe that digital dollar, when the US government, they were considering how to launch their digital dollar. So I think USDC, this is the real test of digital dollar. So I think it's all about stable coins. Let's go next. Then it's liquid tokens. You know, I'm not going to speak about every single token, but here's a pretty long list of all these tokens. And I just wanna emphasize that we chose all the major hot topics now in terms of tokens, and all of them, they are based either on Ethereum or Binance Smart Chain. So it's all hot topics, as you can see here. And of course, every token who exists on both blockchains, we are listed here on Binance Smart Chain on, and on Ethereum, whoever prefer, whatever, you know. So we support all the major tokens based on all major blockchains. So now we move to enterprise solution, and in terms of enterprise, I wanted to explain basic and very important information. So first of all, I have to say here that we do not charge minimum monthly fee either on merchant solution or enterprise solution. So on merchant solution, we charge only one-time fee, $1,000 or $500, just as an onboarding fee. And on enterprise, we charge one-time fee. It's onboarding, compliance, screening, and setup fee all together, just $1,500. And I would like to bring one more time to your attention that here's not any kind of minimum monthly fee. So you are free to use and pay as you go. This is very important, and this is very convenient for all the companies. So here we put all this information and all important information about smart token collection system, which I mentioned earlier. I explained it in details, how it works and what is the difference between the first version and second version. And here you can see that for you, it will give you guys 50% savings on the commissions, which is very efficient and very dramatic discount for you during the maintenance or using or usage period of the system. So also As you know, that if you wanted to activate smart contract, especially our smart contract on Ethereum requires activation, so smart token collection. And this is why we have to activate by paying this 0.15 Ethereum in order to activate this smart token collection. Because enterprise solution, it gives you dedicated gateways for every single blockchain. It doesn't mix with any other coin, so it's pure dedicated solution for every single enterprise coin. And this is why we set up dedicated smart contract for every single enterprise coin. So we charge just $1,500, and we pay from this $1,500, we pay activation fee for smart contract to activate repo address, because as you know, every repo address requires 20 repos. Then Stellar, then Binance chain also requires some activation fee, and then smart contract on Binance Smart Chain also requires 0.025 BNB. So depends on the market rate, every time this like cost can go up or down, but approximately it's 500, 400, 600, sometimes it's $700. It's our cost from this 1,500 to activate your fee. All other wallets and tokens, especially Liquid tokens, free of charge. This is very important. Then, in terms of commissions, as you know, guys, and this is very important, we do not charge any outgoing transactions, which might be settlements, which might be payouts, withdrawals. Any kind of outgoing transactions are free of charge. This is great bonus for you guys, and we never been charged for this even on the first version, and of course we do not charge this on our second version. Incoming transactions, as I mentioned earlier, that we released tiers, and these tiers, they work automatically. They count, we count these tiers, these amounts every 30 days. So it's a cumulative amount of the transaction. The system knows the rate of every single transaction. So we count the existing rate at the moment of the particular transactions by the volume of this transaction. That's how we count national valuation. And for example, you process 2 Bitcoin. So today Bitcoin is 40K, so we count as 80K. Tomorrow Bitcoin is 50K, you process 3 Bitcoins, it's already 150K. So, and every single transaction we plus, we make it sum, you know, and as soon as you reach 1 million, next transaction, commission will be dropped to 0.25, and automatically we will be charging 0.25% up to 2 million. As soon as you hit or reach $2 million volume, like national dollars here, your commission will be dropped to 0.20%. So, and we go here up to 0.05%. So this is very important, and it will help you to grow your business while you will be expanding. Then, very important, all these transactions we do charge, we do apply for stable coins, for coins, and for liquid tokens. What is the difference for liquid token and illiquid token? Illiquid tokens, we consider illiquid tokens that we cannot exchange them, or they are listed only on a particular exchanges where we cannot exchange, or we are not interested to exchange your tokens. So this is why for illiquid tokens, we do not apply any kind of percentage for incoming transaction, or of course outgoing transactions free of charge. So you pay only blockchain fee, and for such illiquid tokens, we charge monthly fee $200 per token. So, which means you can list, for example, any kind of your token, or you even can launch your own token, and you can process 100 millions of transactions, and you will be still paying only $200 for this token, for the processing of this token on our system. So all the liquid tokens we count, we apply just our standard tiers. And here, as we discussed already earlier, in terms of liquid coins or blockchains, we already discussed them when we discussed enterprise solution. Stable coins, everything is the same, no other changes. And in terms of liquid tokens, that's what I wanted to emphasize you, that here on enterprise solution, we have a longer or extended list of such tokens. So if you compare with merchant, we have less tokens there, and on enterprise we have much more tokens here, and this list will be extended, of course, and every single request we will consider carefully from our clients. Are we going to list this particular token that client, for example, wants to add into his account, enterprise account, and if we consider that this token is liquid, then we extend this list, we put this token here, and we do not apply $200 fixed commission here for this token, so we apply this. But if we do not agree and we don't want to list token into our liquid token list, then we apply $200. So that's it. I think it's very simple, and commission structure is very, very transparent. One more time, there is no minimum monthly fee for your turnover, so you pay as you go. On our second version also, we have released one of the sufficient and key function. It's every single enterprise client is able to add any token based on Ethereum, Tron, Binance Smart Chain and Omni blockchains, any tokens based on those blockchains, just in two clicks into their system. So basically, it's a huge progress that we have made, and now all these enterprise clients no longer will have any kind of issues with adding any new tokens that they like or they run on their exchange. So no more problems to add any tokens. Of course, Solana, Polkadot is also on the way, and all tokens that will be available on those blockchains will be added the same way very soon. So what else? Actually, of course, a lot of new security protection layers. You can assign specific rights to particular people. You can make a whitelist of IP addresses. You can whitelist any withdrawal addresses. I mean, you can whitelist addresses where you will be able, or let's say one of your user, let's say from Finance Team, will be able to withdraw there. So we added a lot of new alerting system, limits and so on. So a lot of new protection functionality, which is the key now. And of course, we added new logic behind all the system. It's now it looks even a bit more simple. So we tried to present to you through this simple, like very complicated things in a very convenient way, how to view on it, how to check it, how to check transactions. Of course, there are a lot of new fields. You can find any information you wish, because B2B InPay second version contains all possible information from blockchain, from transaction, from amount, from everything. So, and of course, it's one of the best pleasure bonus for you guys. We decreased commissions and we released tiers for commission. So each tier, it's this tier you can use in 30 days, and every 30 days system counts how much you process through the system, then your volume goes higher, then commission goes less. So that's how we decreased our commissions, and of course the first level is also very attractive, and now you can start processing no matter you are merchant or enterprise, system became much cheaper for you. On our second version, we made integration with several third-party projects. Of course, B2B InPay is integrated with all B2 broker products such as B2 Core, which is traders room for your forex brokers, crypto wallets, any kind of PSP business, any kind of brokerage business. Then it's of course B2 Trader, which is a matching engine trading platform for your exchange. It's perfectly integrated with all the MetaTrader servers, MT4, MT5, Marksman, everything what B2 Broker has in terms of product. So B2B InPay is integrated already there. Also, on top of that, we made integration, we integrated basically B2B InPay with major KYT providers. What is this? What is it? KYT. KYT is a know your transactions. So basically, nowadays you cannot work or run any kind of crypto related business without these KYT companies, because what basically they are doing, they are checking all the transactions, and if you receive any kind of transactions from darknet or from the red marked wallet, so this system immediately notify you that you receive crypto from dark sources, and you have to proceed according to your anti-money laundering policies and procedures. So this is very, very important. And for our merchant services, they don't even think about that. We made already integrations, and we pay to all these KYT providers. We pay them for every single transaction, we pay them, and we take this cost on our side. It's already included into our merchant version, and we immediately notify merchants and we block these transactions, and we notify merchants that their users or some of their users use source from red marked wallets where maybe already was detected some stolen crypto, or maybe it's just from the addresses which are belongs to any darknet marketplace or so on, you know. So actually what I'm trying to say here is that this is, it's very important, KYT. And on our merchant solution, we take care about this KYT. But for enterprise client, of course, we made integration with all major guys such as Chain Analysis, with Crystal and so on, Elliptic. And you can potentially sign contract with any one of them. And we recommend Crystal, you know, we are fully integrated and it's very fun. So you can sign agreement with them, and then you can enable KYT of all your transactions on your enterprise solution on your side. So guys, as I mentioned earlier, that we have merchant solution. It's for any kind of business who is going to use crypto as a payment method. So basically such businesses even cannot be related to any crypto somehow. But if you are selling any goods, any services, any products, any online services, any, you are forex broker, you are regulated casino, you are gambling, betting company. So for all such kind of businesses, merchant solution perfectly suit their needs. And you can choose, of course, your target currency. We call as a target currency, it might be dollar, it might be euro, it might be pounds, it might be any kind of stable coin, USDT, unregulated stable coin, or it might be USDC, first and the biggest regulated stable coin. It might be DAI, decentralized stable coin, it might be Bitcoin, Ethereum. So no matter what you choose, basically it's going to be your target currency, and you can accept all major coins, stable coins, and tokens, and everything, all these coins, tokens, stable coins will be converted to your chosen target currency. And then if you chose, let's say, any kind of fiat currency, dollars, euro, or pounds, you can make a settlement in, you can withdraw basically through bank. So our regulated Estonian entity will make a settlement to your bank accounts from our bank. So we have banks in US dollars, in euros, through SEPA, through SWIFT, and from pounds through SWIFT and through faster payments. But of course, in order to be onboarded on a crypto fiat, in order to be able to choose dollar, euro, or pounds as a target currency, you have to satisfy our compliance department. So we have certain requirements for such merchants. Of course, we have the same requirements for the crypto to crypto merchants. If you chose, for example, any kind of stable coin or Bitcoin or Ethereum, then of course, if you chose any kind of crypto settlement, then you are able to make withdrawals or payouts or settlements immediately as soon as you receive any kind of balance on your chosen target currency. So, and second solution, it's enterprise clients. Enterprise solution perfectly suit needs of cryptocurrency exchanges, of cryptocurrency wallets, of crypto brokers. Basically, any type of crypto related business where you don't need to make converting, because actually your liabilities to your clients, they are denominated in crypto, and you have to store this crypto on your side. So basically you don't do real exchange, right? So you need just blockchain infrastructure, because of course potentially you can take Bitcoin node, you can use Bitcoin API and create make integration with your, I don't know, let's say traders room of your exchange or of your crypto broker, and create all these addresses there, and users can send Bitcoin. But you will face a lot of challenges, let's say, or problems with identification of these users, of how to collect all these Bitcoins, how to make automatical payouts, limits, logics, cold storage, warm wallets, all the functionalities that I mentioned above. So basically it's pretty complicated system, and can you imagine if you need to take care about all I don't know, major blockchains, all tokens, stable coins. So this is why here, through our enterprise, through one single unified comprehensive API, you get access to all blockchains, to all this infrastructure, and you don't need to take headache on your side about how to update those blockchains, because all these blockchains, they sometimes they do updates just, you know, suddenly, nobody even expects them, or something happens, or they need to make a hot fix, and they do it right on the way without even asking or notification to all the crypto community. And especially some kind of blockchains, some of the blockchains, they are you know, pretty close, and their documentation is very poor. They don't keep it up to date. Of course, we do know all these weaknesses of all these blockchains, and we are monitoring them on a daily basis, and any new immediate update is implemented as soon as new release came out. So and also, of course, we are taking care about the servers where all these blockchain nodes is hosted. And don't forget that sometimes all these nodes, they just stuck. So this is why you have to have all the backups of all these nodes. So actually, you know, we take on our side like huge headache, and we charge our first year just 0.4%, and we go down to 0.05%. 5% is just 5 basis points, and for all this headache, it's basically, you can count, this is system free of charge. So as I said, we have merchant solution, we have enterprise solution, and it perfectly suits any kind of business. In terms of integration, I just wanted to show you guys how our system is detailed, described in details, and we released, you know, enterprise guide. So here you can find all necessary information in order to make to understand how it works. Then even we made for you a quick start guide where you can easily understand what you need to do, what kind of steps should be done. Then different how-to articles. Here we try to answer the questions: how to then, how to this, how to protect your account, how to change your password, how to enable 2FA, and so on. So all such kind of questions you can find here. Enterprise API, that's what I was talking about. This is a very detailed API with examples, so with everything for your developers, we'll be happy to integrate this. Besides of our great news of our second version, I would like to share with you one of the also important news, and it's not even published on our website. I guess it's going to be published just in the next 3-4 months. Just for you to know, I really glad to share that we released also our new solution on B2B and Pay, and it's white label solution for any clients who run their crypto PSP or who run their payment business, especially any kind of electronic money institutional companies or any kind of credit card processing companies. For such companies, we were getting a lot of requests from those mentioned type of businesses to get white label of our B2B in Pay in order for them to launch their some kind of sort of B2B in Pay on their side. Of course, you may ask me, why, guys, are you going to provide solutions indirectly to your competitors? And basically, they're gonna launch competitors for your B2B in Pay. But here, I should say that, you know, the crypto market has grown for last 5 years or even 4 years, starting from 2017, I don't know in how many times. It's a huge growth, and it's still just maybe 1% of all market capitalization. I firmly believe that market will be expanded dramatically in the next last 5-10 years. And believe me or not, in 3-4 years, you will start forgetting about even the fiat payments, because since CBDC, central bank digital currencies, came to the picture, now all central banks and all banks, they are going to start releasing it. And the great example is China. It's already passed 2 or 3 tests and it's going to be released. America, through USDC, they already injected their regulated stable coin, basically it's a digital dollar, into the crypto economy. Russia is going next year to release their crypto ruble, and many other countries or central banks, they are working on these projects as well. So we are here facing the huge growth, and this is why we are happy to share our technology with all our partners, future partners, in order to give them ability to run their crypto processing business. That's how their new companies or their existing clients will get access to crypto processing, and their end users of those, their customers, will get access to the crypto or to the crypto processing, and from this situation, everybody will win. So it's a win-win solution for us. We do not consider all our potential partners as competitors. We do consider them as our future partners, and we are ready and we are here to help them to grow their business. Besides all the mentioned things, as you know, we don't like to share our plans. Basically, we tell or we announce when it's already done. But here, I will just share with you three plans what we are going to do. First of all, we are going to release for our corporate clients, for merchants, for enterprise staking. And it's going to be true staking, which means there will be available only tokens or coins where you can store the tokens and become a validator. So it's not gonna be, let's say, staking for USDT, because staking for USDT, it's a synthetic staking. You know, many exchanges, they call staking for all those tokens, even no matter like decentralized tokens or regulated, unregulated tokens. And one of them, it's a USDT. So on USDT, you don't become validator of the network, right? So this is why all the exchanges who is stating that they provide staking on USDT, basically they don't disclose real intention what they are doing with that. And of course, maybe they distribute these tokens among maybe decentralized liquidity pools and so on. They are making some commissions. They give loan, or they, I don't know, they give loan for the margin trading on spot exchanges. That's how they make money, percentage, their interest, and they share part of this interest with their user. So anyways, we are going to release the staking, and stay tuned to be informed about this. Second solution is going to be our custody solution. You know, now demand for the custody never was such high as now. We never seen so many requests for custody solutions, and custody solution, it's very important, because everybody already realized how it's important to hold or to store your crypto in a very secure way. So I'm not going to tell you now all details what kind of custody solution is going to be, but be sure that it's going to be one of the best solutions on the market. And our third point, we are going to release wallets for everybody, and these wallets will be for all users of all our merchants, and these users will be able to do off-chain transactions, not on-chain, off-chain transactions between users and merchants, which will increase the speed of the transactions and settlement. So that's our plan. And guys, I was really glad to inform you about all these mentioned things. And please, if you have any kind of questions, just let us know, b2binpay.com or b2broker.com. Just leave your request and our business development team will reach out to you shortly. And of course, I'm here always with you, Artur Razizov, CEO and founder of B2Broker, and see you around. Bye-bye.